नमो गोभ्यः श्रीमतीभ्यः सौरभेभ्येव च नमो ब्रह्मसुताभ्यश्च पवित्राभ्यो नमो नमः। नीलाचल निवासाय नित्याय परमात्मने बलभद्र सुभद्राभ्यां जगन्नाथाय ते नमः। मन्नाथ श्री जगन्नाथ मद्गुरु श्री जगद्गुरु मदात्मा सर्वभूतात्मा तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। I bow to the Divine Mother in the form of Gomata. I bow to her as the mother of the entire creation. I bow to Lord Jagannath. I bow to my beloved Gurudev. I bow to all the saints and sages of all religions and all places. I bow to all present here and present everywhere as the form of Lord Rama and Mother Sita. Siya Rama Maya Sab Jaga Jani Karahu Pranama Jori Jugapani. Today is the 6th day of Go Navaratri, 9 days celebration in honor of Go Mata, Mother Cow. On this occasion, we are celebrating in a village in Rajasthan, Kirodi. The entire celebration is organized by the villagers with full of unity, amity, and fraternity, with full of inspiration and motivation. Here the villagers are running a beautiful goshala, having couple of thousands of cattle population. To commemorate this program, we have 7 days talk on Go Bhagavatam by the Pithadhishwar of Malukpit, Vrindavan. I bow to Pujya Maharaji, who is sitting and adorning the seat of Sage Vyasa. In the year 1966, on the holy day of Gopashtami, when countless sadhus, saints and sages, even common men, sacrificed their lives with the brutal step of the government on the silent assembly of about 1.5 million of people, sadhus, common men, along with many prominent spiritual personalities. The backbone of the movement to stop cow slaughter was really broken. Since last 26, 27 years, Godham Pathameda has taken a positive step to serve the cattle population Gomata, Govansa, as the living presence of God. And there is a constructive movement, Rachanatmaka Karyakrama, to bring the message, the science of mother cow to common man. Since 2012, personally, I am inspired and motivated by Gaurushi Pathmeda Maharaj and his exemplary personality, life of complete dedication, and the practical service through Pathmeda. And I feel myself blessed to be involved in this movement in spite of all limitations. I bow to Pathmeda Maharaj. Again, I bow to you all. I'll tell you one incident which happened in the year 1947, November 3rd, in Puri. You all know Puri is a prominent place of pilgrimage for the Hindus. And it is also the seat of the Shankaracharyas in the East. On this day, there was a program in a Vedic school. The governor of Odisha, Kailashnath Katju, those who are elderly people, they might remember him, a very powerful politician. He was the chief guest. Then His Holiness Shankaracharya of Puri, adorable Swami Bharati Krishna Tirtha, was the chief speaker. Governor has his protocol. The program started. Pujya Swami Jagadguru Bharati Krishna Tirtha, he started speaking on the glory of the Vedas. The governor Katju interfered. He stood up and said, "I have an objection to His Holiness. We the Hindus speak very high of the Vedas and our culture, but it is too much. And not only that, to say that the Vedas have solution to all human problems, it is too much of exaggeration." Bharati Krishna Tirtha was a unique personality. He was integration of humility, spirituality, and unusual memory and knowledge. Just for information, he had 7 master's degrees. And in each master's degree, he was the topper, gold medalist. He knew more than 14 languages. He said, "Mr. Katju, what I am telling, I know and I tell. The Vedas is the storehouse of knowledge. Unfortunately, we are ignoring it. I will give you a very simple example of mathematics. All mathematics problem can be solved with only few sutras of the Vedas. Now it became, instead of a program of the school, it became a debate on knowledge. For practical demonstration of Vedic knowledge in mathematics, blackboard to write with the chalk was brought. Swami Bharati Krishna Tirtha asked the governor, you write down any problem, any multiplication of any digit with another any digit, it can be done in no time. So Katsu took this challenge and took the chalk and wrote a big number and then another big number, then another big number like this. Then he sat down. Pujya Jagat Guruji called a 15 years young student of him, disciple, solve it. This young man of 15 years age stood up and just wrote the answer. Again the governor interfered. I don't believe in it. I want step by step. You might have some magic, some mantra, tantra. So this 15 years old young man did it step by step, very quickly. Seeing this, there was a complete change in the mind and heart of the governor. He had tears in his eyes and he bowed at the feet of the Shankaracharya and asked, how long will it take for me to master this knowledge? He said, 6 months. 1 hour, 2 hours, 6 months practice, you can do it. It is not a big deal. You will be surprised to know. Governor's car every day came to Govardhan Pit. Why do I tell this on this occasion? India got independence nearly 75 years ago. We had the opportunity to have our own educational system, own agricultural system, own economic system, own defense system, everything of our own based on the Vedas and scriptures. Unfortunately, the government after independence, with blind imitation of West and being European in heart, Indian in skin, imitated the European model of development. What happened? 75 years we are going to complete. What has happened in India? Can you tell that it is progress? India has progressed a lot. With my little knowledge, knowledge in economics, knowledge in science, I'm telling, it is not development, it is destructive development, not constructive development. In the name of so-called economic development, in the name of so-called revolution in agriculture, in milk production, and so on, we have made India as a place of poverty, diseases, sickness, dirty uncleanliness everywhere, sense of fear, sense of insecurity. The chance which God gave us in the year 1947, we missed it, and 75 years of suffering. Now is the chance. Again, God has given some chance to people of India. I am not telling to praise any party or party in power, but after 75 years, we have a hope that the mistakes done 75 years ago, partition of India is a big blunder. Not following the Vedic model of economic development is a big mistake. Not following the cow-based farming and agriculture is a biggest mistake which is really irreparable. And all these mistakes, some of them have been solved. For example, previously Kashmir was considered as, now Kashmir is declared as the integral part of India. Ram Mandir, going to be finished, but this is not enough. This is like toffees to the children. The real challenge in our front, near the government we request, and to all the citizen of India, why citizen of India? I request people of the entire world to listen, to think how to be healthy, how to be happy, how to be joyful, how to have good memory, how to live a good divine life, the Vedic knowledge, the Vedic way. And these problems are many, and the solution is one. We want good health, we need good food. If we need good food, we need good drink and good agriculture. And for this, cow is the solution. Gomata is the solution for all the problems we have. It is not just blind belief. India has given to the world few things. Unfortunately, people in India are forgetting it. Mother cow, in the yogic lifestyle, practice of yoga for preventive and curative health system, to prevent diseases and to cure diseases, Ayurveda and vegetarian food. These are the few special gift of India for the entire humanity. On this special day, special occasion of Go Navaratri, I humbly pray to all the citizens of the world, I humbly pray to all the people of India, awake. Be aware of the real problem. Don't be sick, run to the doctor. Don't be unhealthy and live unhealthy way of thinking, speaking and food habit. We can change our lifestyle, we can change our attitude, we can change our attitude towards mother cow, go mata, and bring a complete transformation in the environment, in the family, in the society, in agriculture, in food, everywhere. With these few words, again I offer my love and devotion to Pathmada Maharajji and his tireless effort for the cause of mother cow, and I offer my respect and regard to Malukpit Maharajji, who is sitting here on Vyasapit, and I bow to all of you. Let God give us real strength to us to fight for the holiest, noblest, and the most divine cause of Go Mata, Mother Cow. Jai Go Mata, Jai Gopal.